And at 9:37, there's that sound we love. It's Water Cooler Wednesday. And here today, Michelle Lewis from FM 100, Kevin Cerrito with the I Love Memphis blog and Sports 56, and our own Todd Demers. Drum roll, please. Thank you.
Ba-dum-bum.
Thank you. Okay, a new show premieres tonight on CBS and News Channel 3, and this one sounds kind of interesting. In the briefcase, families experiencing financial setbacks are given a large sum of money and an even bigger choice. You can keep all the 100 grand in the briefcase or share it with another family in need. Let's watch.
This decision has nothing to do with me. It has to do with my family, my girls. That's what makes it hard. But I want them to look at me when they grow older and say, I'm proud of you.
Now, what they do not know is that the other family has been given the same amount of money and the same choice, so it's sure to be interesting. Michelle, let's start with you. What do you think you would do?
I know what it's like to struggle and to go through devastation and tough times and have to survive. I would share, and I would like to hope that others would too. Yeah, there's good in people. You got to look for it, and I hope that's what this show brings out.
Kevin?
First of all, I think the show, I'm excited to watch this show. It seems like the CBS hit Undercover Boss mixed with a little bit of Deal or No Deal or something. But I would probably not share, because I'm thinking, well, like everybody could use some money. And like if you go to the casino and you win oodles of money at the casino, when you're walking out and you see somebody who may not be necessarily as well off as you or a similar situation, you're not going to share the money. And if somebody came up to you and asked you to share the money with this person, you'd be like, I just won this at the casino.
Yeah.
Fair and square.
Yeah.
I still, as someone who's been through a lot, who knows what it's like to have to go paycheck to paycheck, if I know that that person needs it as much as me, I'd be willing to share. I stand by what I say.
How would you feel if you shared and then the other family didn't share back, Todd?
Oopsie, I wouldn't feel very good at that at all.
Can you take it back? Can you do a do-over?
Yeah, we'll see what happens with all of that. That's going to be very interesting. I think it puts everybody at home in your position. Mm-hmm. You're basically kind of the instrument for what people at home are thinking. And I have a feeling it's going to be a mixed bag of reaction, just like what you just heard here. Some are going to say, oh, no, I'm going to give. And others are going to say, well, you know, I need that money right now too. Mm-hmm. And I think there's an option where you can go like half and half, or you can give some and keep some. So
right.
I think there's a lot of different
options. Well, now
options.
That would be nice, but that would make it too easy.
I know. See, we need to have the drama.
There'll be a conversation starter for sure. Okay, so how about this? The Scrabble dictionary. We got some Scrabble players.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, oh yeah, words with friends, stuff
okay,
like that.
Okay, well, you got some new words. You added a lotsa of them, in fact. Yes, lotsa, L-O-T-S-A is one of them, along with FaceTime, twerking, lulz, L-O-L-Z, Bezzy, which stands for best friend. I didn't even know that. And ridic, of course, short for ridiculous. So, you know, what I'm thinking is twerking with a Q-U. That would really give you some points, Kevin.
On the triple word score.
You have to spell it with a K. What do you think?
Well, they said they're doing this to try to appeal to the younger generation. And if they are, like you pointed out, Todd, they probably should just rename the game Word with Friends, the board game, you know, Words with Friends, the board game, if they want to get kids to start playing it more.
Yeah.
I hate this idea. I'd be totally
it.
On
the,
all those crazy words. It's like I'm going, these aren't words. I mean, it used to be when you're growing up and you're playing Scrabble, this was one of those things where you really had to think. You had to get some really, and
yes.
Now they're just throwing anything, they're seeing what sticks. And it's like, okay, Michelle, there were a couple of them in there that I liked, but not all of those. Some
okay,
of them were really crazy.
You're making me upset. Uh-oh. My instant reaction was yes, because as humans we evolve, and one of those things that evolve is vocabulary and words and emojis and twerking. These have become real things.
Yeah, but ridic?
I say ridic all the time.
Changing.
I live my life with a breeve. And you mentioned words with friends.
Did you say you live your life with a breeve?
With a breeves. I use a breeves. And you mentioned words with friends. I get so mad when I'm playing a friend and I write emoji and it says, this is not a word. I'm like, it is a word.
Well, that's a word.
It's a
I
word.
I still maintain ridic
right.
is ridic.
Uh-huh. Some of them are bad spellings of words that are already existing on this list, and I think that's kind of crazy. Next, they're going to start inserting, like, you're going to be able to play smiley faces on your
the ones that are proper, like photobomb. Photobomb's a real thing. Selfie.
Right.
Todd's
so,
words
so
is the
word.
King of selfie.
Oh yeah.
Okay,
my
we're getting the
too.
Word "rap" right now in my ear. Okay, actress Maggie Gyllenhaal just told the Rap magazine that she was turned down for a part because of her age. The 37-year-old, who is hot, we can all agree with that, says she was told she was too old to play the lover of a man who is 55. I'd love to start with Michelle, but I'm going to start with Todd. What do you think about that?
Well, you know, directors have got to do things to make their movies work, and they have a certain look that they're looking for, and I'm sorry because I really like her, and I think she's a great actress, but that director apparently said, this is not going to work for me, your look, your... I don't think the numbers have a whole lot to do with it. I think it has more to do with what she looks like.
Oh, so you don't believe it.
Whether she looks older, she looks younger, whether, you know, that kind of chemistry is going to work with a male co-star. So I think this is a pretty isolated incident.
Michelle's going to beat you up.
I think this is ridiculous.
We're going to wrestle here in just a minute.
Because I do think it's ageism. It's a Hollywood thing. And Meryl Streep said it best. It's really easy to put old age on. It's very hard to take old age off. And what's the big deal? Unless she wasn't right for the part, totally different thing. But if it really was about her age, come on. Yeah. Absurd.
Well, there's other roles she can start playing now if she's too old to play these type of roles. But, yeah, I mean, I agree with you. It's men can go and they can be in movies. Like, and you think, what movies can an old man not be in? You think, maybe action movies. And then they start making Expendables.
Right.
And, like, you can be 60, 70 years old and be in an action movie. There's nothing a guy can't be
doesn't matter anymore,
no
right?
No matter their age, yeah.
I'm with Michelle. It's ridiculous. Thank you so much.
Thank you. It's ridiculous.
Coming up, how to cook the perfect steak with experts from the Peabody Hotel.